Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalatu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala ahli baytihi at-tayyibin at-tahirin. Firstly, I would like to thank all the attendees who accepted the invitation of the Global Association of Muslim Women and have attended the seminar today. Thank you all. I would also like to thank Hujjatul Islam wal Muslimin, Dr. Shamali, the respected representative of His Eminence Ayatollah Al-Uzma Sayyid Ali Khamenei Hafizullah Ta'ala in England, and his colleagues at the Islamic Center of England for their efforts and cooperation in organizing this event. We are at the moment approaching the month of Muharram, the holy month of Muharram, a month which is the remembrance of the greatest revolutionary movement against tyranny and oppression in the history of mankind. Recognizing Imam Hussein, salawatullahi ta'ala, and understanding the objectives of his uprising and obedience towards him and the revival of his message is the biggest responsibility of the true lovers of Imam Hussein, salamullahi ta'ala alayhi. I repeat it again because it is very important. Recognizing Imam Hussein, salamullahi ta'ala, and understanding the objectives of his uprising and obedience towards him and the revival of his message is the biggest responsibility of the true lovers of Imam Hussein, salamullahi ta'ala. Imam Hussein, salamullahi ta'ala alayhi, in the beginning of his uprising, stated, "Inni lam akhruj asharan, wala bataran, wala mufsidan, wala zalima, wa innama kharajtu li talab al-islah fi ummati jaddi. Uridu an amura bil ma'ruf wa anha anil munkar. I did not rise for oppression, corruption, greed, or rebellion, but I rise for seeking reform in the nation of my grandfather, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam." I want to enjoin the good and forbid the evil, and to act according to the tradition of my grandfather, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Therefore, the aim of the uprising of Imam Hussein, salamullahi ta'ala alayhi, was the elimination of oppression and corruption from the human society, and creating peace and establishing justice in the community. This objective is the sum objectives for which the prophets were sent to implement. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated in chapter Al-Hadid, he said, "لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط." Indeed, We have sent our messengers with clear proofs and revealed with them the book and the balance, justice, so that mankind may keep up justice. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in chapter Shura commended the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam and stated, قُلْ آمَنْتُ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ مِنْ كِتَابٍ وَأُمِرْتُ لِأَعْدِلَ بَيْنَكُمْ. Say, I believe in whatsoever Allah has sent down of the books, and I am commanded to do justice among you, O mankind. Those who consider themselves to be followers of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam and the followers of Ahlul Bayt salamullahi ta'ala alayhim, especially Imam Hussein salawatullahi ta'ala alayhi, have a great responsibility during these times when the enemies of Islam and enemies of the Holy Prophet and his Ahlul Bayt have all united to destroy the tradition of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his Ahlul Bayt, and try hard to destroy the religion of the Holy Prophet and his Ahlul Bayt by different means, especially by creating division among Muslims, and they try to degrade and disgrace the followers of the Holy Prophet and his Ahlul Bayt, salamullahi alayhim ajma'in. It is the duty of all of us to organize all our strength and ability together to revive the path of the Holy Prophet and his Ahlul Bayt, especially Imam Hussein salamullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in. And by keeping vigilant and aware of the conspiracies of the enemies of Islam, we must fulfill the following responsibilities. First, the most important responsibility of all the followers of the Islam and the Holy Prophet and his Ahlul Bayt salamullahi ta'ala alayhim is maintaining the unity and solidarity of the Islamic Ummah and confronting any conspiracies of creating division and discord among followers of different Islamic faiths, Islamic schools. The Global Association of Muslim Women have the ability to expose the conspiracies of the Zionists in creating division among Muslims by making use of the educational abilities of women and by using the media facilities. Second, our other responsibility is gaining a better understanding of Islam and Islamic leaders, especially Imam Hussein salamullahi ta'ala alayhi. In the text that I read to you from Imam Hussein salamullahi ta'ala in the beginning of my speech, Imam Hussein salamullahi ta'ala alayhi has publicly announced the aim and objective of his uprising, which is seeking reform in the Ummah of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, and acting according to the tradition of the Holy Prophet. This is very important to understand what is the aim of Imam Hussein of his uprising, especially in these days, in the month of Muharram, in the 10 days of the first 10 days of Muharram. And acting according to the tradition of the Holy Prophet and Amir al-Mu'mineen, salamullahi ta'ala alayhi, we have the responsibility of clarifying these aims to the public, especially to the followers of Ahlul Bayt, salamullahi alayhi, and to inform them that any act which would create division and corruption in the community is against the aim of Imam Hussein, salamullahi ta'ala alayhi. Third, according to the previously mentioned verses from the Holy Quran, establishing an Islamic government and creating a government of justice in accordance to the divine laws has been the aim and objective of the Prophet and the Ahlul Bayt, salamullahi ta'ala alayhim, especially Imam Hussein. The aim of his uprising to establish a just government, just ummah, just society. In his uprising in Karbala, Imam Hussein in his Karbala, his aim was to establish the just society, the just government. Therefore, the thought of separating religion from politics or opposing an Alawi Islamic government which is based on the school of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the teachings of the Ahlul Bayt is the same as opposing Islam and the Holy Prophet and his Ahlul Bayt, salamullahi ta'ala alayhi majmai. We hope that the Global Association of Muslim Women will take great steps in implementing the aims and objectives of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his Ahlul Bayt, especially Imam Hussein. Thank you all. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.